Will you now cite some other examples of the practical application of imagination?
Take, for example, Dr. Alexander Graham Bell's research in connection with the modern telephone. Here we have an example of the use of creative imagination, for Bell's invention was basically new. Let us say that he, like Edison, stumbled upon the principle that made the telephone practical while searching for some mechanical device with which he could create a hearing aid for his wife, whose hearing was impaired. Here again we find a man who was inspired by a definite purpose, which assumed obsession proportions. His keen sympathy for his wife was the factor that gave obsessional force to his purpose. In this case, as in all others where men give obsessional proportions to their desires, a definite motive was behind his desire. Motive is the beginning of all desires. Through a long period of research that is too involved in details for description here, Dr. Bell's subconscious mind finally presented him with an idea which served his purpose. It became known to the scientific world as Bell's experiment, the substance of which was this. A ray of light is cast upon a plate of selenium, which sends the ray back to another plate, some distance away, of the same metal. This latter communicates with a galvanic battery, to which a telephone is attached. The words uttered behind the first plate are distinctly heard through the telephone at the end of the second plate. The ray of light, accordingly, has served as a telephone wire. The sound waves have become transformed into light waves, the latter into galvanic waves, and these have become once again sound waves. Thus, a basically new principle for conveying sound waves was uncovered. It has been claimed that the principle, in part, was suggested to Dr. Bell by the experiments of a man by the name of Dolbear. There was a lawsuit over the priority of right to the principle, but Mr. Dolbear lost the suit, and Dr. Bell was declared to have been the discoverer of the working principle of the modern telephone. At any rate, Dr. Bell's desire for a mechanical hearing aid for his wife, backed by a persistent search for such a device, led to the discovery of the principle he needed. It must be remembered that the subconscious mind makes use of every practical means available for revealing knowledge to those seeking it with obsessional desire. It performs no miracles, but it makes intelligent use of all practical media available in carrying out its purpose.